Hello everyone, this is Sumit from GATEbandhu, and today we will take an example from artificial lift technique, particularly for gas lift, and we will see how to solve that example under artificial gas lift. This is the example taken from the complete drawn volume 2A, where we need to find the point of gas injection. The data given is for a well, total depth is 8000 feet. The desired rate is 1000 barrel per day, it is 100% oil. And tubing size is 2 3 by 8 inch, that is equivalent to 1.995 inch ID. Flowing wellhead pressure is 100 psi. And static bottom hole pressure is 2650, say it is here, 2650 psi. And the productivity index pi equal to 2, that is q by delta p, that is static bottom hole pressure when well is not flowing at all. Solution GR is 200, specific gravity of gas is 0.7, surface operating pressure is 900, somewhere here, we call it P surface operating, it is called P tubing, 100 psi, and flowing temperature is, you will see how to solve it for the point of gas injection. The desired rate is 100 barrel per day, that will be 100 barrel per day divided by P bar, that is 2650 minus the flowing bottom hole pressure, PWF, or called flowing bottom hole pressure. If we solve this, a simple, the delta P will be q by pi, that will be 500 psi, and will be solve this for PWF, that will be 2150 psi. So the we mark different pressure at the pressure curve, this is the depth axis, if we mark the 2150 psi, that we call it flowing bottom hole pressure. So actually when we at the 8000 we mark the static bottom hole pressure and we mark the flowing bottom hole pressure, okay, somewhere here. Now, what we need to do is to calculate, we need to draw a static gradient line from the static bottom hole pressure, for which the oil API is given, that is 40 API, and we need to calculate the equivalent PSI per feet from it. So to know the equivalent PSI for feet from 40, corresponding to 40, it will be around 0.357 PSI, 0.357 PSI per feet, and how it is calculated, I will take it in a different video. 3.357. This is what I call it, say, aptitude part involved in this question. Either way, it is all the process involved and the concept based question, how to do it. But we need not to draw the graph for it. That will be another aptitude based questions. So from point of from the static bottom hole pressure, we draw we draw a gradient line. And if we simply use that gradient, that is 0.357, that will intersect the depth axis somewhere at 1978 feet. What we do, we now calculated the flowing bottom hole pressure, that is somewhere here. We, for the simplicity, we take the parallel line from it, but for actual case we need to draw this taking the 200 SCF per day, that is the solution GOR, and the API gravity involved with the oil. That will be somewhere tilted, but the trend will be, for simplicity I have taken the parallel line. This is the static gradient line, this is the dynamic line that will be involved. So now, from the surface operating pressure, from here, a gas of 0.7 specific gravity will be injected. So what we do, from this 900 surface operating pressure that is marked here, we draw the gas gradient line. And for simple case, this 0.7 psi that will come out, that is for again a given chart, but if it not given here in the GATE examination, you will be given a psi for fit, that will be 21.2 psi per 1000 feet gas gravity. And if you draw a gas gravity line, this is a 0 feet. If you draw a gas gravity line from here, it will intersect this dynamic line somewhere at this point. We call it this, this point is called point of balance. Point of balance means when fluid is filled in the dynamic case from here to here, the hydrostatic pressure of this oil filled in the tubing will be equal to the 900 psi plus the gas hydrostatic pressure. That will be equal. That means if it is filled at this point at the valve, the no flow will be there. So we need to have a 100 psi. So we need to have a 100 psi pressure. We need to move along this equivalent to 100 psi, and we mark this point equivalently, that we call the point of gas injection. So we took 100 psi just to make the delta P 100 psi along the wall to make the gas flow from annulus to tubing, into the tubing. So we mark it as a point of gas injection. The process involved in this will be, we draw a axis, x axis and y axis, and mark the psi, sorry, pressure here and depth here, and it is given the depth is 8000 feet. So it is like sand face, the reservoir is at the 8000 feet. So desired 100 barrel per day, we calculated the flowing bottom hole pressure required for it for given PI, that is given 2. So we got it 12150 psi, so we marked there, and this is flowing bottom hole pressure. Now we know that oil having a specific gravity will have a some psi per foot gradient. We draw a line that intersected at somewhere 1978 feet. And this is a static condition, but when dynamic condition you need, there will be a different dynamic line. This is the dynamic line given for it. So at the dynamic line, when gas will be injected, you will see the point of balance. So from gas will be injected from surface at the pressure of 900 psi, and when this is injected, this will gain some pressure because of the restrict pressure above the 900 psi and reach a different depth. The point of balance will be somewhere 4800. This point of balance reach somewhere at 4800 feet, and when we do the 100 psi decreasement in the pressure, so it will be around the pressure required for point of gas injection will be 4.6. This point will be 4625 feet. So the point of gas injection answer will be 4625 feet. You got it right. So another extension of this question will be to calculate the exact volume of gas required per day at the gas port. So we will see this in the next video. Thank you.